Hey guys, Dan here, aka Wolf, and today we're going to discuss the exotic animal encounter connection between Ellie and Abby in The Last of Us Parts 1 and 2. As usual, stop now if you want to avoid spoilers or forever hold your peace. In the hours leading up to Joel's Day of Wrath at St. Mary's, Ellie and Abby each have their own powerful encounter with an animal descendant of the zoo in Salt Lake City. Both moments have striking parallels and stark differences that foreshadow what is to come in the next 5 years in both of these young women's lives. On the exact same day, in a moment only hours apart from each other, Ellie and Abby's dual encounter with an exotic creature native to another world is somewhat reminiscent of an archetype of medieval folklore, specifically the Maiden's encounter with a unicorn in the wilderness. The otherworldly unicorn was a symbol of purity and grace that could only be tamed by the Maiden to harness the creature's ability to heal the sick and neutralize poisons, which reminds us of Ellie's potential to protect mankind from cordyceps. Legends held that if this sacred creature was betrayed and the unicorn wounded or injured, this could have the utmost dire consequences for the kingdom. The zebra caught in the barbed wire subconsciously calls back to Joel helping Ellie through the barbed wire fence on their way to Jackson, suggesting that Joel has broken this pact with the sacred encounter. Even though the fireflies free her, the fate of the kingdom is sealed, and there is nothing they can do to stop the darkness that is to come. There will be no cure. It is interesting to point out how mirror opposite these two scenes are despite their similarities, and what these differences suggest for each of the girls' immediate futures. Ellie's encounter with the giraffes is a peaceful and serene moment that both the player and the characters don't want to end, foreshadowing the 5 years of general happiness Ellie will find in Jackson, living with her adoptive father. The giraffes are encountered moving in herds, suggesting the solace Ellie will find at becoming a part of a community after living in fear of abandonment her whole life. Abby's encounter with the lone zebra is the complete opposite of this, stressful and full of tension. The zebra is hurt and in distress, and the threat of bodily injury to Dr. Anderson and Abby keeps the player and the characters on edge the entire time. We want the scene to be resolved quickly because it is stressful to experience from every angle, foreshadowing the terrible losses Abby is about to endure, both the murder of her father and the destruction of her Firefly community. Joel and Ellie are in a building and up high, which suggests the relative peace and safety they will find in their new home, whereas Abby and Dr. Anderson are on the ground in an open park, vulnerable and exposed, blinded by the surrounded trees, unable to see the danger that is racing towards them in the hours to come. At the giraffes, there are only two characters, Ellie and her adoptive father, whom she will eventually lose as an ultimate result of the actions he's about to commit later that day. At the zebra, there are three characters, Abby, her father, and the man she loves, Owen, both of whom she will lose, perhaps suggesting that Abby will lose far more people she loved than Ellie in the fateful chain of events that Joel's Day of Wrath will set into motion. Ultimately, Ellie's encounter with the giraffes and Abby's encounter with the zebra represents innocence lost, as depictions of these animals in art and in plush toy form are a recurring motif associated with children throughout both games, most notably in Ish's underground classroom in the first game, as well as painted on the walls of the WOLF classrooms in the sequel. In the moments before her encounter with the giraffe, Ellie is staring at an engraving of a stag as the spring chapter begins. As Joel tries multiple times to engage her, Ellie is uncharacteristically quiet, no doubt reflecting on her traumatic killing of David, as triggered by memories of the stag that brought them together. It is only her initial sighting of the giraffe that shakes Ellie from her solemn state, rekindling some measure of her inner light that this desperate world so eagerly seeks to steal from her. In the moments before Abby's encounter with the zebra mare, she is running alone in a forest, calling out for her father in an echo of what is to come. Once she finds Dr. Anderson and they set out to track an unidentified creature, Abby passes through the gaping maw of a whale, foreshadowing that she will soon be entering the belly of the whale, a difficult part of the hero's journey where a character is thrust into an overwhelming situation of dark despair that will threaten to consume them completely, but offers the chance of rebirth, as symbolized by the mare's afterbirth she finds shortly shortly after. Abby also passes through the tentacles of a giant squid immediately following her exit from the well, suggesting to our subconscious the epic dual symbolism of the whale and the giant squid, foreshadowing what will ultimately take place between Abby and Ellie in the game's climax and again during its conclusion. Lastly, the giraffe and the zebra are both prey animals, showing that both women are ultimately victims of events originally set into motion beyond their control. And while prey animals they both may be, the giraffe is formidable and powerful, despite its deceptively cute appearance, with kicks and neck attacks capable of killing predators in a single strike. Remind you of anyone? Well, that's all I have for now, y'all. If you enjoyed this video, you can help me build something great by subscribing to the channel and sharing this video with others. You can say hi to me on Twitter if that's your thing, and don't forget to leave your love in the comments. Until next time, I'll catch you in the wilderness.
Dan, also known as Wolf.